Two.
Rosie Fashano, three. Three. Five.
Four.
Eight.
Two.
Eleven.
Fifteen.
Rosie Fashano, four.
Six.
Ten. Zero.
Two. Eight. Four.
One.
Two.
Thirty-one.
Forty-nine.
Forty-four.
Eleven. Thirteen.
Thirty-six.
Sixteen.
Rosie Fashano, two.
Thirty-nine.
Two.
Forty-one.
Fifty-five.
Two.
Nine, two.
Two.
15. Mike Russell, 17. 5.
37.
8.
32.
39.
13. 15.
34.
42.
5.
18.
45. 36.
51. 53. 56.
48.
41.
59.
54. 55.
51.
53.
34.
35.
36.
36.
36. 36.
39.
44.
42.
42. 60.
44.
43.
47.
47. 41. 83.
Just the rest of them.
I 39.
This.
41.
Sounds 32.
43. 46.
Sounds 38.
No intake.
56.
56.
Rajiv Sharma, 11. 56.
61. 63.
52. 54.
55.
66. 68.
57.
70.
9.
41.
72.
46.
74.
40.
51.
76.
54.
78.
31.
36.
31. I'm rolling.
5. Sharma, 23.
Campbell Lynch, 2.
Maya Petrov, 28. Forty-six. Forty-eight.
Forty-five.
Arden.
two?
Yes.
Look at shot, if you think my person.
So I'm scared to go to five. So I'm scared to.
Nine. The deep.
I
Hicks.
Solomon Scary.
37. 39. Lucas Shaw, 39.
6.
2.
8.
5. 8.
4.
And which?
14.
My first, 8, Lucas Shaw, 2.
16. 3.
5.
6.
4. 6.
Lucas Shaw, 8.
6. Heath.
Second.
21. 24. 26. 38.
21.
6.
31. 33.
And Lewis.
36. 38.
3. 51.
6.
41.
11.
43.
37.
11.
46.
37.
48.
52.
Sean.
37.
50. 53. 55. 75.
And a Lynch.
3.
38.
78.
6.
80, Will Fagoni.
Second, Shaw.
6.
3.
43.
6.
3.
6.
88.
5.
5.
91, Will Fagoni.
And a Lynch.
94.
Simon Skerritt.
5.
96.
3.
99.
5.
Number then 1.
2. 2.
4.
4.
7.
3.
4.
6.
5.
5. 6.
7.
And a Lynch.
6.
11.
10. 15. 15.
6.
18.
5.
Number then 18.
2.
53.
2.
24.
3.
3.
25.
8.
4.
26.
6.
8.
53.
30.
39.
43.
7-4.
7-6.
43.
7-6.
49.
46.
7-4.
48. my personal opinion. Six.
Solomon Scary, six, four. Thank you.
47.
Virginia Shama, 13.
38.
17, 41.
51.
4.
41.
53.
53.
10.
5.
56.
48.
Simon Scary, 10.
59.
151.
61.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the exciting closing stages of this group match in the 2019 Endeavour Life Care World Billiards Championship here at the RACV City Club in Melbourne. I'm David Pitt, and we're watching Rupesh Shah at the table in his clash with Mike Russell of England, Rupesh from India, both former world champions. And at this stage, Mike Russell with a handy lead of about 90, but of course there's about 15 minutes to go, so plenty of time for Rupesh to win this game, should he play out time. Interesting shot selection here. The obvious shot for most people would be the simple in off the red or possibly a cannon, but Rupesh has identified a shot where he can play a lovely screw cannon, sending the white in and out of book and absolutely right behind the spot. That's a great shot. Perfect pace and perfect direction. Just leaving himself, the red over the hole, the white, the yellow behind the spot, and perfect top of the table position. This goes over there, and he's absolutely in. So 65 to go. That break brings him up to within about 80 or 90 of Mike, and we're set for a very exciting finish. Just a little bit straight on that red, but with a nice screw back off the side cushion, he's corrected that angle, and now he's in a perfect angle for this cannon to pop the red over the pocket, kiss off the yellow, and leave himself simple enough. He would have liked to have left himself a pot there, but the angle on the cannon wasn't quite right to do that. Just pushed that a little bit too far, Rupesh. He would have preferred to leave a pot red, but he's got a simple short jenny, which will bring the red out for a pot, so no dramas at all for a player of his class. Both really almost in the childhood prodigy class, these two. Rupesh won his first Indian National Championship at the age of 19, which is quite remarkable in a sport where it takes decades to master. Mike Russell, of course, won his first World Championship at the age of 20, which is absolutely extraordinary, and he's gone on and won that title 12 more times. Again, Rupesh just a bit straight on the red, but screwing back off the side cushion, correcting the angle to leave himself in perfect postman's knock position.
90.
Modern billiards postman's knock isn't the preferred way to play if you're under the balk line rule. So you'll see the players these days trying to knock the white off the side cushion. as he was on 92 then, he needed to cross the balk line between 80 and 100, which he did successfully then. But it's always a risky proposition because you're never really sure where the cue ball is going to go. And he's left himself a difficult shot here. Oh, he's just not quite managed to force that. So not very nice 95 break there by Rupesh, leaving him only 57 behind. And he's left, really, he hasn't left much here for Mike at all. There's nothing that anybody would particularly fancy here. We'll see what he can come up with. Yeah, he's played safe. That's a very good shot. That he's left the red almost on the ball cushion. If that had gone another foot or so, or bounced out off a bit more, that may have left an in off red into the left-hand ball pocket. But he's played it with beautiful strength. Rupesh can get it off the white here, but he's going to have his work cut out to get the red in play. Just forced that one a little bit wide. These strawn superfine cloths that we're playing on here at the RACV Club this week are very sensitive, and forces particularly can tend to go wide. Mike just play safe here. He's got the lead. He's just quite content to force Rupesh to make the running in this scenario. And Mike can just sit back and play safe until an opening comes. Yeah, that one missed by quite a long way for a top player. And he's managed to fluke the white, leaving himself a long lose. He's still got plenty of work to do to get the red back into play. Our referee for this match at RACV is Praveen Chandra, a local referee from Victoria. He lives down in the country, but he's come up here this week to referee, like many of our visiting referees from overseas and interstate, and he's here for the whole week, refereeing three or sometimes even four matches a day. So four shot there from Rupesh actually worked to his advantage because now he can double ball Mike, leaving him with a bit of a conundrum. Rupesh has got an in off the red. It's a little bit thin, or maybe it's a run through. It's not quite a half ball. Difficult for Mike here to know where to put his cue ball safely. So he's just rolling it over to the side cushion. Rupesh with a couple of options here. He can play a screw cannon off the yellow. He's got a big ball, so he can play this off one or two cushions. He'll screw this off the yellow back into walk like that. That's a beautiful shot, but just on the wrong side of the red. Yeah, it's not too bad. He's got a shot here. He can just play a gentle cannon, push the white over the pocket, hope that he gets a nice contact on the red so that he can pot the red and continue his break. Oh, he's done exactly that. That's a great shot. Just looked so simple, but he had to leave the yellow away from the pocket, and he had to leave himself straight on the red. He's done both of those things perfectly. That looked like just a simple shot, but he actually had to play that with great precision, which he's done. So at this stage, the pendulum's swinging back in Rupesh's favour. He's now got both balls out of balk. Civil in off the yellow into the middle pocket to set up a drop cannon, and Mike will just be sitting in his seat as you have to do in billiards. There's nothing you can do. It's not like a combat sport like tennis, where you're reacting to your opponent's moves, and the balls are coming towards you. The balls are just sitting there waiting to be struck, and when you're sitting down, then you are out of the game completely. Oh, the vicissitudes of billiards. That yellow ball has just come and smothered Rupesh there, so he can't see the red. He's got to play a run-through cannon. There may be a danger of a double kiss. So just a nasty turn of the balls, but that happens with drop cannons. So he's playing this as a run-through cannon with strong right-hand side. Got a beautiful angle here from Dan Lynch, our producer. Lovely shot. Played that perfectly. Kept the wide away from the middle pocket, although it's gone to the cushion. He's not going to be too worried about that. He'll be able to rescue that. So he's now cutting the red up towards the middle pocket. And from this position, he can put the red almost anywhere he likes. We'll see how he handles this. This is an object lesson for anybody who's watching, just to see the different ways that these top players handle these scenarios. Yeah, very interesting. He's actually played to counter those balls together and knock the promote the white up over the pocket, which he's done. But in doing that, he's left the red on the cushion. So he's kind of swapped one problem for another. Again, plenty of options for what he could do here. He could just dribble this in and leave the two balls close, or he could possibly hit the yellow into the red and push the red down towards the pocket. He's done that successfully. Didn't quite get the red as deep as he would like, but the yellow's gone across into an in-off position, so it's okay. He won't be unhappy about that. So the clock's running down here, 5 minutes 42 approximately. The clock that you're seeing on the screen isn't the match clock. There's a separate clock there, but we're confident that the timing that you're seeing on the screen is relatively accurate. He's just left that one a little bit short, which leaves him in a tricky position. A thin direct cannon on the right-hand side of the yellow. But difficult to control these. You've got to hit these thin but slow. This is a telling shot, this one. Ooh, he's just hit it too thin and missed altogether. That's a big surprise. So once again, the fortune swing. 30 seconds in front with 5 minutes to go. Mike only needs probably a 30 or something. It's a nice slow 30 to just chew up the clock. And he's in business. Mike, I've been watching him play this week, and he's the absolute master of adapting his game to the requirements of the situation. He had a tough match yesterday against David Cosgrove from Australia, who led and played very good billiards against Mike. Towards the end, Mike got in. Well, that's a bit of a lucky break for Mike there. That kiss just put him straight behind the red. Against David, he had a scenario. We just needed to make sure of the win, and he just played middle pocket losers for about a 30 or 40 break, which put the match out of reach. And you'd think he might be doing something similar here. He's not going to... He'd probably not be wanting to go to the top of the table at this stage, because there's a danger of a smother if he does that. Probably this is the time to be playing some open billiards. But then, who am I to be telling Mike Russell how to play? Yeah, nice shot there. He's played a good control shot there. Got a nice angle on the cannon. Perhaps a little wide. He's just lifting his butt there to get plenty of side and just swerve into this little shot. No, it's a stun actually, not a swerve. A bit wider than it looked, and he's basically butchered that completely. But with a 40 lead and 3 minutes left, I'm tipping he'll be playing safe here. Just thin off that ball, taking his yellow over the side cushion, and just trying to keep them safe. Rupesh has got a shot here. He can play off the left-hand side of the yellow with side to come back down, but I think the clock's going to beat him here, even if he gets them in perfectly. He's played a great shot there. Beautiful shot. Landed perfectly on the outside of the red. He needs about 40 in 2 minutes. He's going to have to get his skates on if he's going to do that in the 2 or 3 minutes that he's got available. He's just playing steadily. There's really no need to rush in these situations. Inevitably, what happens when players rush in these close finishes is they miss. The trick is you've just got to play out time. And if the bell beats you, so be it. This is the position here is problematic. He's got to pot this red, and it was very difficult to hold the white. To leave it in off He would have had to actually put that red into the side of the pocket to get position there. If he gets this, he's a genius. He's a genius. That was a great shot. That was a great shot. So he's 22 behind. 1 minute 30 left. He's just brought the balls down. Would have loved to have gone to the top there to wind these up quickly, but this is tricky. Okay, that works. The red could just pop up here for him. Yeah, he's got the balls in front of him, so he's got a couple of choices. It's no snack. Yeah, beautiful shot. That just dropping on the outside of the red. Around a minute to go. He's got he's 16 points behind. This clock that we're looking at on the screen may not be accurate. He may actually have more time than we think. And the way he's playing, it would suggest that he's actually got more than 40 seconds to go. He's probably got a minute or two left. And he's certainly playing like somebody who's just timing this break, so he hits the front with about 5 seconds to go. Because the last thing you want to do is get to the front too early. Oh, this could be a smother again. Drop cannons, they're deadly. I think he's okay. He can see the red. Lovely work there from Dan Lynch, our producer, showing us that close-up side angle where we could see that, in fact, he had a clear shot of the red. Yep. Three, he's eight behind. Pot the red. He's just going to come out for a half-ball loser. Oh, no. Oh, he's... Well, an incredible finish there. Rupa Shah in play, playing slowly, lost by 5 points in that tremendous round-robin match here at the RACV Club in Melbourne, Australia for the 2019 Endeavour Lifecare World Billiards Championship. So probably the closest result we've had between the top players in the tournament so far. And Dan, let's hope that we're going to be able to dish up plenty more good matches like that. That was a tremendous finish and quite difficult to understand. How Rupesh just didn't speed up a bit. He just needed to go a little bit quickly, more quickly, only needed to score, you know, two or three times more to hit the front. But he took my advice, took his time, and he was beaten by the buzzer. So great to see. We'll be back at 2 o'clock for the next round of matches in the 2019 World Billiards Championship at RACV, and keep watching on World Billiards YouTube channel.
Furniture, we guarantee better results for students with our Learniture range of ergonomic school furniture. We have more than 50 years of experience in designing educational furniture solutions. Reed also offers a range of flexible, modular furniture which is easy to reconfigure. Transform a classroom from a collaborative learning space to a workshop or an instructor-led environment within minutes. What's more, everything comes with a 10 years warranty.